Hey, everyone. This is AV. Today, we will delve into how to integrate the React drop-down tree select library into our React code. This library has two direct dependencies, array.partial and react-infinite-scroll component, as well as one indirect dependency, throttle-debounce, which is required for react-infinite-scroll component. To get started, we first need to install the package using the following command, npm I react dropdown tree select save. Afterward, we'll import the dropdown tree select component from react dropdown tree select and include the default CSS styles as follows. Now, let's use dropdown tree select like this. It comes with numerous properties that we'll explore one by one. The data property is essential, while the rest are optional. The texts property comprises three internal properties: placeholder, which labels the field, inline search placeholder, used to label the search field for filtering values from the drop-down. No matches, which replaces the text when no matching values are found during filtering. The keep tree on search property displays search results in a tree structure rather than flattened results. The inline search input property determines whether the search input renders inside the drop-down content, like this. If false, it would appear differently. The clearSearchOnChange property clears the search input when a node is selected or unselected. The keepOpenOnSelect property keeps single selects open after a selection. Please note that this only works in combination with simple select or radio select modes. The show partially selected property displays checkboxes in a partial state when some, but not all, of their children are selected. The read-only property makes the drop-down read-only, allowing user interaction without changing values, useful for display-only forms. The disabled property completely disables the drop-down. We'll discuss the data property later. The onChange hook fires when a node change event occurs and calls the handler with the current node object and all selected nodes. The onNodeToggle hook fires when a node is expanded or collapsed, calling the handler with the current node object. The onFocus hook triggers when you open the drop-down, while onBlur triggers when you close it. The className property is used to give the drop-down a class name, enabling complete customization using CSS. The mode property defines how the dropdown is rendered and behaves, with four options. Multi-select dropdown supports tree data with parent-child relationships, allowing multiple selections. The default mode. Hierarchical dropdown. Selecting a node has no ripple effects on its descendants or ancestors. Radio Select dropdown allows selecting only one value while preserving the tree or children structure. Simple Select dropdown turns the dropdown into a simple, single select dropdown. If you pass tree data, only immediate children are picked, grandchildren nodes are ignored. The show dropdown property lets you choose the rendered state of the dropdown. Initial shows the dropdown when rendered. Useful for rendering the component with the dropdown open initially. Always shows the dropdown when rendered and keeps it visible at all times. Disabling dropdown toggling. The disable popping on backspace property indicates that when a user triggers a backspace key down in the empty search bar, the tree will not deselect nodes. Now, let's explore the data property, which expects an array of objects. Each object should have a label, which represents the option's name displayed in the UI. This is the only required key, the rest are optional. The value is the option's value when selected, and if not explicitly set, it takes the label as the default value. The class name allows you to customize the styling of a particular option using CSS. The checked property marks an option as pre-selected. The disabled property makes an option unselectable or disabled. The expanded property shows all the children of a particular option, making it expanded by default when you open the dropdown. The children property provides another array of objects with the same values as the parent, and this structure can continue recursively as needed. The custom data is an example I've provided. If you wish to use custom data in drop-down hooks, you can pass it with any custom key value pairs and retrieve it as shown. So, this is how you can use and integrate React drop-down tree select in React. I've covered almost all the major real-world use case scenario properties, but there are more properties available that you can explore on the npm.js repository. I hope you found this video informative. If you did, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.